Number two, huge lawns are everywhere, growing on a small spot for centuries. The same spring comes every year, the same winter departs every year, with the same beauty and unchangeable freshness. Lawns can be walked on by college fellows. Lawns can be viewed when a college is not closed to visitors. All around are sighs with their owner's titles. Huge trees are occupying huge spaces, leaving no chance for any new beings. A blackbird who perches on the back chimney of Keys College, it claims its territory at dusk. It sings beautifully. A moving mouse breaks his neighbor's privacy while digging a humble hole. Too small a world. Apologize? No. Dark crowds are waiting in the shade of trees, patiently. Murphy proves that one day, a bad mood of a single person turns the whole earth dozens of times into heaven. All makes money. All things in the world are begot from somethingness, and somethingness comes from nothingness. Lao Tzu says, 2,500 years ago. Churches still serve bread and water, but fewer and fewer comers. People go traveling a lot nowadays. Hiroshima is a good place to take pictures. A pigeon is drinking in cam. People love pigeons. Sun.
康亨里流淌着过去和未来，却没有现在。孔子来到卡奈尔桥上叹息，侍者如师傅不舍昼夜。美丽的黄色花瓣散布在女王学院的路上，真稀罕，朋友肯定地说。多少世纪所积累的繁杂条文， 培养出驯服，自由，想要自由，往左看还是往右看？以前帮你的习惯，现在却会要了你的命。一位骑车的中年女子摔倒了，她说：“汽车的风太猛了。”一辆汽车呼喊着陌生人，在窄窄的街道上飞驰而过。 地面颤抖着，将冬眠的蛇都唤醒了。肯定不是自行车手设计的，也许是一位不喜欢免费医院的人。捐赠。Number three. Past and future runs in the cam constantly, giving no place for presence. Confucius stands on clay bridge and sighs. All that passes is here. Beautiful yellow flowers are strewn on Queen's Road. Very rarely, my friend assures me. All complicated rules of centuries cultivate obedience. Liberty, wants liberty. Look left or right. Instinct that helped you will kill you now. A middle-aged lady fell down under his bicycle. The bus wind was pushing, she told me. A speedy car sounds alien in the narrow road. The earth trembles, waking up all snakes underground. It must not be designed by a cyclist, by a man disliking free hospitals, perhaps. Donation?
是。
醉醺醺的诗人变成了艰涩的诗人。 你不需要博士学位， 可我需要工作。 我不是那孩子， 我需要朋友。 怎么样让你成为诗人？ 什么使你伟大？ 在怎么样和什么之间的一条线， 将你变得一文不值。 削尖你的铅笔往干枯的地上沾，肚子这样说：自由，不能自杀，否则你的灵魂将受到惩罚。好吧，我活下去。Drunken
poets grow into difficult poets. You do not need a PhD degree.
I need a job. I'm not that child. I need friends. How makes you a poet? What makes you great? A line between how and what makes you nothing. Peel your pencil and drill into dry earth. Stomach says so. Freedom? No suicide. Or your soul will be punished. Okay, I will live on.
五，绅士早已老套，早已过时了。可我的课本上的绅士形象那么好，嘿，英语变化很快，英语闹个及格都很难。他拼命地读，使命地喊。 后来成了一名英语广播员，据说还说上了一口标准美语。疯狂英语风靡整个国家，成千上万的学生和他一起疯喊，他挣了不少钱。可是英国人从来不大喊大叫，他们吃饭时都抿着嘴唇，他们走路很快，一切都很安静，除了大街上撩人的接吻的噪音。
他没法教他们学习英式接吻。Five. A gentleman is antique and old-fashioned, but it means all goodness in my textbook. Well, English changes rapidly. To get to 60 English is so hard. Read crazily and shout crazily. He eventually became an English broadcaster with a pure American accent, they say. Crazy English speak sweeps across the whole nation. Tens of millions of students are crazy and shouting with him. He makes a lot of money. But the English people never shout. They eat with lips shut and walk with quick paces, all in quietness, except for kissing noisily in the streets. He cannot teach them to kiss English kisses.